the most beneficent, the most merciful. In the name of the one whose names are so beautiful, so suitable to begin, every syllable is for him. El Khalaq al Insan, creator of mankind and jinn, every noun, verb, and synonym I dedicate to him. He who taught mankind the names of all things, and so to begin, all praises to him. To be or not to be, your being is still for him, for he is one with no father or son, and the only one worthy of your prostration. He who controls the moon and the sun, every atom, including Adam, may peace be upon. Indeed, the best speech is derived from the Quran and the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I seek refuge from Allah, from the accursed shaitan, because I came from a prophet who was the best of creation. So let me begin with the greetings the angels gave to him. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa
barakatuh. I put a lot of work into that salam, by the way. That was no regular salam, and I expect a little bit better in return, inshallah. Let's try that again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Okay, we work on that, inshallah. We get better, inshallah. Those who criticize my generation forget who are the ones who raised us. Produce teenagers who pop and razors, scraping their veins open like erasers. Trying to erase all the pain and shame of delinquent teenagers on call with drugs and alcohol, having a ball while our species is in danger. Because in this day and age, you are nothing but a Facebook page, a retweet of nothing sweet, a selfie inside a cage. Living in a material prison, a 16x9 cell of whatever celebrities on your TV want to sell. Because everybody wants to be somebody, but nobody wants to be themselves. We adore the ones who ignore us, and ignore the ones who adore us. We are only Muslim by name, so long as immigration won't deport us. I'm sorry, Mr. Politician, I didn't mean to look so different. I know my parents have a funny accent, but I'm just working with what I was given. You see, we moved to these lands to escape from poverty and persecution, but colonization of my nation kind of had the promised lands looking like an illusion. And I don't know what I'm doing, where I'm from, or where I'm going. You see, I wanted to go to school, but the class they put me in is boring. The teacher says that I have special needs and that my grades ain't that important, but they don't know that I could flip trees and by three buy me a pair of Jordans. And I don't want to play the race card because I ain't even a fan of poker. But every time I visit jails, it looks like the colored people taking over. But as I've grown older, I've realized what's most important, and I don't ask Allah for less tests. I ask Allah for bolder shoulders. Because inside of every tear is a moment most sincere to God. The help of Allah is near, but how near are you to Allah? Because in order to be free, you must escape from the prison of your desires and speak only when your words are more beautiful than silence. Make friends with the Quran because it is a book of guidance. Embody the message of messengers and stand tall like that wounded the giants. I was looking for faults and so I started in the mirror. And I realize my real homies are those who want to be homies in Jannah. And though people are complicated, Islam is real simple. You see, Allah gives us so much, but yet we thank Him so little. But now even liberals see my sisters wearing hijabs as criminals. But I see every covered girl as a covered girl, so take cover, girl. And forgive your enemies, but never forget what they have taught you. And know that those who gossip with you will one day gossip about you. They tell me I should rap to the youth, although my poetry is spoken. I tell them my tongue is a loaded gun and I am careful where I point it. Plus, I ain't trying to give advice that I've acted upon myself. Everybody wants to change the world, but nobody wants to start within themselves. But from what I can tell, the signs are clear. The end of time is near. And behind every wrinkle on the face of our elders lies wisdom beyond our years. If only we would take a moment to attain all that they had made. One generation plants a seed so that the next can receive the shade. People ask me what changed. But wallahi, akhi, nothing really. I just began to see this world as a traveler and I'm moving quickly. On my way inside my grave where everyone will sleep. Because the angel of death is a celebrity everybody's dying to meet. People say that they are killing time, but really time is just killing you. And your life is nothing more than all the paths and roads that you will choose. But even a man who killed 99 people and repented to Allah was excused. So if you say your heart has grown distant from Allah, then ask yourself who moved. Growing up is painful, but you can't stay small forever. Everybody wants a rainbow, but ain't prepared for bad weather. So never, ever, ever let the devil make you sad at where you are, because only in your darkest hour can you see the brightest stars. Some of the best lessons in my life were learned at the worst times. But I wouldn't change anything except my patience and the divine. Because if Allah brings you to it, then He will bring you through it. Just have patience and pray. Trust me, I'm living proof of it. Jazakallah khair. Somebody forced you to be here? No? You can smile, you know, it's okay. You should see this camera. By the way, this camera keeps zooming in on everyone's faces, and you don't notice it, but you just look like this. Following the sunnah, brother. I'm upset. It's okay, you can smile. No problem. This is not my first time in Africa, by the way. I've seen this many black people before, alhamdulillah. I've traveled all around Africa. This is my first time in Kenya. And it's, you know, very beautiful. I feel like I'm one of you. I feel Kenyan. People don't know. They think I look Kenyan, by the way. They just come up to me and start talking. Brother, how do I do? Yes, I agree, yes. I like it, it's nice. This is really an honor, you know, subhanAllah. Actually, before I continue, can I just do one thing? Just so I can remember this moment. Can I take a selfie with you guys? Is that okay? Can I do that?
Yes.
Okay, but you gotta like wave or something. Don't just look dead. Man, you guys are so black, I don't see anything. Look at this, there's a problem with the splash. What is going on here? Just a bunch of black people smiling, that's all you can see. Are there any, like, white people here with us? Where? You said yes, where are they? You're waving your hand. You're not white, you black. Don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to us, sister. We know you. Don't lie. Come on. I'm very honored to be here. Wallahi, I can't tell you this enough. It's actually, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed me so much that I've been able to be here with you all, you know, accompanied by some great scholars and great individuals. And me, I'm just like miskeen, man. I don't know nothing. I just came along. This guy's trying to interpret my poetry. I feel like so bad for him. It must be so difficult. Because I'm talking so fast and I feel like he's not really getting. Is he still going, mashallah? He's good. He's good, mashallah. I give him credit, mashallah. But for many of you, this is your first time coming to an event like this. Alhamdulillah, in North America, we have conferences all the time. But it's great because you get to see so many different people. Just out of curiosity, just so I know who I'm speaking with, how many of you are under the age of 25? Raise your hands. MashaAllah, look around. Everybody here is young. How many of you under the age of 23? Raise your hands. Under the age of 20, keep your hands up. Under the age of 18, 16, 14, 12, 10. You're 10 years old? What are you doing here? How did you even get in? Okay, now, how many of you have birthdays on January 1st? That's a joke overseas. You don't get it. In North America, all the East African people, birthdays January 1st. Because they come to America and they don't know what day they were born, so they just say January 1st. Anyways, that's fine. Alhamdulillah. It's great to see so many young people. You know, alhamdulillah. I have a message for the young people. I'm young myself, sort of. I'm getting older. But alhamdulillah, I sympathize with the young people because being a Muslim in this day and age is not a very easy thing. Doesn't matter where you come from. Doesn't matter what continent or country or city you live in. Islam is consistently under attack. We have with us so many great blessings, alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you the opportunity to access knowledge like never before. You have access to Islam like no one else has had before you. You have scholars, you have du'at, you have masajid, you have halaqat, you have so many opportunities, you have the internet. Imagine that, just through online, you can access Islam at the click of a button. You can learn about your religion very easily. But I would still say that for the majority of us, we're still very ignorant about Islam. Islam for many of us, it's just a cultural thing. Why are you Muslim? You're Muslim because your parents told you you have to be Muslim, that's why. Most of you never woke up and said, you know what, today I'm going to be Muslim. Today I'm going to practice Islam. For many of us, Islam was just something that was given to us. 8 years old, 9 years old, you're in Duxi, mashallah. You don't even know what's going on. You're just there, right? You don't have a choice. Many of us, we don't understand or appreciate the blessing that we have. You know, there are people outside of this room right now who are walking around so hurt, so lost inside. If they knew what you had, they would trade the world for it. If they knew what you had inside, they would give up everything for it. But for many of us, our Islam is just a part-time thing. We have part-time Muslims. You know what I mean when I say part-time Muslims? Like, yeah, you're not full-time, you're getting minimum wage Muslims. And you have different type of part-time Muslims.